So my family roots are in Pennsylvania Dutch country. And in Pennsylvania Dutch country, pot pie looks like this. You see, you put the dough into the pot with the broth and the chicken and the vegetables. I would contend that this is authentic pot pie. This is just pie. It's my favorite debate, actually, so another time you can come and talk to me about that. But food study scholars like me just debate and discuss things like this all the time, and I want to focus today on authenticity. Authenticity is a salient topic in today's food landscape. In an age of mass production, we're seeking often something that's real, something that is linked to a culture, even if it's not our own, not something that's plastic or fake, right? And food is a great avenue for that. It's deeply symbolic. It's also very material. So in a sense, it's a great way to explore authenticity. And while there's no one way to define authenticity in the scholarly literature, because let's be honest, there's not consensus on anything in academia, basically, we can kind of view it through a couple of lenses, one being traditionalizing and one being otherizing. So I'm going to talk about both of these and talk about some of the unintended consequences of these forms of authenticity in food. First of all, traditionalizing. This basically means that authentic food through the lens of traditionalizing is linked to the way it used to be, to a place usually as well. And when we consume that food, we're buying in sort of intimately to that tradition. And so that's why it's so salient and important. In Italy, where I do a lot of my work, the rhetoric around food is littered with these terms. Come una volta means basically the way it used to be. Artigianale means artisan. Fatta a mano means handmade. And we have those terms here in the US as well. In Italy, the DOC designation for wine is a place-based designation. It basically tells you where wine is from. It's like the French appellation system for wine. But it's now entered the popular language. People in Italy are now DOC. They're from a place, authentically, truly. And even soccer clubs, the famous soccer team from Italy, Juventus, has renamed their fan club, Club Doc, kind of linking to this authenticity. These are the true authentic fans. My pot pie example is also an example of this lens of traditionalizing. As you can imagine, it comes with some debate and discussion from regulation at the European level for approved methods for producing traditional cheeses like Gorgonzola, to discussions at the dinner table about whose stuffing recipe is most like grandma or grandpa's. When it comes to otherizing, the otherizing lens can focus on the indigenous other, but often focuses on the ethnic other or the outsider. And food that fits this sort of category of authenticity often comes with the idea that it's low cost, it's out of the way, or at least out of the way for me, if I'm not in the group that's the other. And then the quality is high, and we would describe that as an authentic experience. Krishnendu Rai wrote a book called The Ethnic Restaurateur, and in this he argues that that what we really seek from ethnic other authentic food experiences is that the restaurateur provides us with a true copy of our expectations of authenticity. And what happens then is that if that is low cost, out of the way, high quality, it pushes and pressures the producer or restaurateur to maintain that low cost, that high quality, and potentially low wages and poorer quality of life. It also can reflect deep societal biases as well. For instance, we wouldn't expect authentic French food to be cheap, right? Italian food went through this same cycle. In the early 1900s, nutritionists cautioned against eating too much Italian food because its strong, bold flavors, these were American nutritionists, these strong, bold flavors would drive us to drink too much alcohol. In this 1892 issue of Good Housekeeping, which is at the library, you can go find it, it explains how tomatoes, which feature strongly in Italian-American cooking, were thought to be carcinogenic or toxic. Contrast that with now, when Italian food is often thought to be refined and costly. So, what do we take from all this? First, our search for authenticity through food can be a response to a sort of mass production society. We're searching for something real, and food is a great avenue for that. It's deeply symbolic, it's material, it is real. Second, the idea of authenticity implies a standard, as if there's one general standard authentic, when actually it's a negotiation between our expectations and the experience that we're provided. So seeking that authentic meal is actually kind of a futile search. And third, our search for authenticity often comes with some consequences, from dinner table angst about stuffing or pot pie to to reflections of deeper societal biases. So my advice is keep seeking authentic food experiences. I know that I will, but keep in mind too that it's in the eye of the beholder. And therefore, it really is true. Authentic pot pie has no crust, at least my version. Thank you.